4 amazing movies with twists, turns and a great plot line to improve your English. Visual treat, perfect cinematography and what a great dance. Hello everybody, how are you all? Hope you are doing great. So welcome back to another session of Learning English with me. Well, in today's lesson, I have another set of 4 movies, 4 awesome movies through which you can improve your English. Again, I have covered lots of genres and today's movies are going to be extra special because they are my personal favorite and they are something that you must watch. So, 4 movies through which you can improve your English speaking skills, your intonation and your pronunciation. Are you all ready for this? I'm Shivangi Gupta, your CELTA certified English language tutor, certified by the University of Cambridge, the UK. And before beginning, please subscribe the channel so that you do not miss out on any lesson that I post for you on the channel. Also like the video and share it with your friends too. Now, coming back to today's lesson, 4 movies. 4 awesome movies that are going to help you improve your English. Now, these 4 movies are something that you must have known before. Stories which are popular yet with a twist. So, I'm not going to reveal much right now here. I'm going to tell you everything about the movie, how you can use it to improve your English, which area of English you need to pay attention towards. I'm going to tell you everything while I'm gonna recommend those movies. Are you all ready for it? Then let's begin with all the movie recommendations now. Movie recommendation number one. Movie recommendation number one is Maleficent. Maleficent. Now, Maleficent is a Disney original movie, a Disney movie. It is a Disney movie, but it has great impact and the message that this is giving you is great. Basically, it's a movie which is taking a different perspective on the story of Sleeping Beauty. Now, we all know Sleeping Beauty, the story of Sleeping Beauty, and there was this villain character in that particular story, Maleficent. In this particular movie, Sleeping Beauty is not the protagonist. It is the story of Sleeping Beauty, the fairy tale, but this is story of Maleficent. Why she is Maleficent, why she is the way she is, it's her story. And she's not a villain anymore in this particular story. It's like redeeming the villain character. This is a totally different take on the story of Sleeping Beauty. So many twists, so many turns. And this is strongly challenging the concept of true love. So this movie is saying that true love, the concepts of true love that fairy tales have always told us, that kind of true love is the only form of true love? No. So it's a very beautiful bond. I'm not gonna tell you what kind of bond in this movie that has been depicted because I want you to go and watch it. Plus this character of Maleficent is quite a strong character. And once you watch this movie, you're gonna see her in a different light. Not as a villain, but as a very strong woman. So I want you all to go watch Maleficent. And the role has been played by Angelina Jolie. And she's one of the most sought after Hollywood actresses. So go watch Maleficent. It's a great, great depiction of Sleeping Beauty with a huge twist. And a great lesson at the end. You'll get to learn normal conversational English. You can hear it. You have to pay attention towards vocabulary, good source of vocabulary, pronunciation. Pay attention towards the intonation. You can also do shadowing speaking practice if you want along with this particular movie. So, Maleficent by Disney. Movie recommendation number two. Movie recommendation number two is Snow White and the Huntsman. Now again a fairy tale, age old fairy tale, but with a different story. Totally different perspective a different storyline where Snow White is not a damsel. She is not a damsel in distress. She is not somebody who would need support of a prince for survival. Watch a warrior princess at play. So in this particular story, in this particular movie, Snow White and the Huntsman, the role of Huntsman is changed. So if you know the story of Snow White, there is a Huntsman who's been sent by Snow White's stepmother to kill her, to kill Snow White. But here, the role of Huntsman is changed, totally changed. And you need to watch this particular movie for this beautiful take on Snow White's story. Totally different take, and this is again giving a very good message. So again, a fairy tale that has been taken and that has been twisted, turned and presented into something which adds meaning. The narration style, visualization, everything, it depicts Grimm's brother's style of narration, of storytelling. Now, if you are from literature background or you love stories, reading, you know who are Grimm brothers. Grimm brothers, they are said to be the father of fairy tales. But their fairy tales are a bit dark with some twists to them. So this particular movie is a Grimm brothers style of storytelling, depiction of Snow White's story, Snow White and the Huntsman. So go watch this particular movie and improve your English. Movie recommendation number three. Now, movie recommendation number three is actually a musical, a fairy tale musical, that is Into the Woods, again by Disney, a Disney production. Into the Woods. Now, Into the Woods seems so enchanting. The name, the poster, everything. Actually, it is a very enchanting movie with, again, great moral lesson at the end. Now, this particular movie is a mixture of lots and lots of fairy tales which are going parallel to each other. Now, characters from different fairy tales are interacting. They're coming face to face. They're going to their way. And because they're coming face to face with each other, they will somehow enhance each other's story. And these fairy tales, the stories, they're gonna get changed. Again, a fairy tale with a changed ending. So I think we can see a particular theme today, a theme in this particular movie recommendation session. The theme is normal fairy tales are age-old fairy tales, and then twisting them, turning them, giving them an edge and representing them with a particular purpose. So great movie, Into the Woods. Now you'll find the story of Red Riding Hood. Red Riding Hood, the little girl who went to her grandmother's house and there was this big bad wolf waiting for her. So that is the Red Riding Hood. Another story that is going parallel in this particular movie is Cinderella's story. One more story is going parallel, that is Jack and the Beanstalk. The Jack that climbs the beanstalk and then he meets a giant up above in the clouds. So that is Jack and the Beanstalk. And the story number four is The Baker's Wife's Tale. Now that is another fairy tale, Baker's Wife's Tale. Now these four different stories are going parallel and they are gonna cross each other, intermingle. And there is great screenplay, awesome storytelling, and it's quite interesting to see what will happen when four different stories will come together at one point and what will be the end result, what is going to be the ending of this particular movie. So that is what you must watch and look out for. Improve your English with Into the Woods. Now, because this is a musical, you have ample and ample of opportunity to sing along. Everything is in a singing manner. For example, right in the beginning, as soon as the movie opens, the narration scene, the first narration scene is where the girl is saying, "It's a really nice day." So it's a really nice day. She is kind of singing the lyrics. Whatever she wants to say, she is saying it in a very rhythmic manner, because of which listening to the dialogues becomes very easy. Understanding the movie becomes absolutely easy Plus, great way to practice English speaking, because when they are singing it, when they are saying their dialogues in a sing-along manner, like rhythmic manner, it's easy to speak out with them, out loud. That is kind of sing along with them. So please use this particular movie for your speaking practice, a great movie to improve your English. Movie recommendation number 4. The last movie, and the theme will remain same. The movie is Cruella. Cruella. Now Cruella is again a villain, a Disney villain. So if you have seen 101 Dalmatians, 101 Dalmatians is a movie, an animated movie of Disney. And this particular movie has this villain character, that's Cruella, a woman. But the live action movie, Cruella, that I'm suggesting to you is the story of Cruella. Why she is Cruella? And what if she was not a villain? It's a totally different take on her story. Again, something usual, taken up, twisted up, and a different perspective. So the theme is, again, continuing in this fourth movie too. Story of the villain, who is not a villain anymore. We are viewing her as a normal human being, as a normal person. And there are lots and lots of hardships in her life, which made her into the person she is. But one thing that I really love about this movie is that this is gonna inspire you to achieve your dreams, to run behind them with passion, with vigor. And if you do it, you can achieve it. So it's the story of Cruella, this ambitious girl, not the villain. And I totally love this particular perspective on this character. Very strong character. Very strong female character, I have to say. And you'll have great time watching this particular movie. You can watch it with your family. All the movies can be watched with your family. And have a great time improving your English. Improve your English with Cruella. Again by Disney. These are the 4 amazing movies with twists, turns, and a great plot line to improve your English. Visual treat, perfect cinematography, and what a great dialogue delivery. All the 4 movies will help you improve your English speaking skills, your pronunciation, and your intonation. So what are you waiting for? Go watch them and improve your English. That's it for today. That is it. I'm gonna meet you again in a new lesson. Till then, everybody, take care and bye.